Right, we are going to build, or I am going to build, my base in the snowy area. There's the vehicle I brought up here, and I put 8 miners down to gather this stuff, xenite. They also gather all the ores, actually. All the different types of ore. Of course, you need the xenite for the higher tech stuff. In order to make the higher tech stuff. Right, I have placed down one frame so far. Now I'm going to build phase mode. And okay, so I've got the base foundation. Once you've got the foundation down, I need to put down the large container. Move all the materials in there. And then stick an item dispenser on the large container. That way you can then use everything within the container without actually being connected to it. It's kind of like magic. It saves a lot of hassle. Uranium generator I'm going to use to power up the 3D printer, fad machine. That's for making food and drink and all that sort of thing. Refinery. Of course, we need the refinery to create uranium for the generator, and the conveyors to connect all the machinery to the container. Right, let's get to it. Let's just finish that one. Now we're going to build a 4x4 base. I've already done this once in another area, and the video was at over an hour long. See if I can do better this time. Come on, speedy. Foundations just made out of plating Mark 1 and basic frame. Right, so that's the flooring down. Ground. Next, build phase mode, and we want that large container. Getting mixed up with the controls from Pyrogalactic Survival. Keep on hitting the wrong keys. Right, let's place that there. Let's see, I want to put a building here. That's a bit too far. I need to move it further to the right. Yeah, I think that'd be okay. Okay, these connectors here, that's for the conveyor belt system to connect to the different machines. There's the contents of the container, and loads of slots, 120. Right, so that's in. Let's stick in the item dispenser. I'm becoming tired, shut up. Damn it. It's very low, actually. Quickly, just going to the stasis chamber to boost that up. 100 energy, 100 food, 89 hydration. That'll do for now. Now to install the item dispenser. That's right. Oh yeah, that thing. Number three. Now I can stick everything, all these components in here. Not that, that's food. Plating, basic frame, electronics, mechanical pots, more electronics, take two, one. Some of that bio stuff, we need that. Okay, so we got that, got that. Let's put in, might as well put in the generator. Can't do anything else without putting the generator in. So stick that in the center. Might that get in the way of, no, it should be okay. I need uranium. 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 Go over to my machine. Ooh, get that build face mode. Uranium. 10 lots here. That's good. I've got anything here I could do moving over. Yes, all of this. Right now, the auto miners are powered off of the uranium generator that's on the vehicle. Yeah, the reason why I've actually put so many miners down is because iron, mostly, mainly because of iron, it doesn't seem to, the machines don't seem to generate or harvest as much of that as it does the other more required ore. 1 million years later. Okay. Uranium in there. I'm going to split this because I need to create another uranium generator to power up the also miners. Right, so yeah, that's in. Now, need. Actually, I want to place. Medium 3D printer. Stick that here. And actually, well, I remember stick a refinery down. Which one's the refinery? That's it. 7. Made most of the constructed most of the components already. Well, there should be enough components to make everything. Never know, something might go wrong. All right, let's just while we're here, put in the conveyor. Oops. Use X to change the orientation, and then the mouse wheel to actually turn the object. Okay. Ooh. Now we want one of those. That tool to finish it off. Come on. So that'll now feed off of that. It'll take all the components out of the constructor. It actually creates uranium and some other fuel source. I'm not sure what that is. I think it's some water-based one. Right, put power. power to that and to that. Now I'm gonna put the frag machine here and the armory here. Compact frag machine for food and drink. And haven't got the armory down there yet. Six. Fed machine. Medium armory. We just placed. Let's say six. That's going to be in line with that. It's going to go around to there. That's one of the lower ones. Let's see that. Oh, it needs to come over. Damn it. Yeah, that's done it. Okay, so zero. And an L1. Oops. Set the orientation. Slightly thirsty, am I? Fiddlesticks. Okay. Hydration back up to 85, that'll do. Right. Okay, both those are now connected. Let's put some power to it. To them. There you go. So we got the armory in place, got the compact fed machine, got the 3D printer, got the refinery. Need a large greenhouse. This will produce plants. Well, certain plants, herbs and whatever. Useful in the medic bay to create medicine and the like. I'm stuck. Right, what do we got? Let's go around there. That will come this way, connect to there. Energy, and that's going down. Let's do this and then I'll put the character in the stasis chamber. Another L1, which is 8. Jump pack so useful. Right, now that can see everything in there. Obviously it needs power to it, so do that. C then connect electricity. Boom. Right, that's everything connected up. Nice. See, so crates, herbs, and fruitage. So you make other food and also medicine, different types of medicine. I'll put in the medic bay. I'll put the stasis chamber and the medic bay in there. And they'll also be powered off by this. Okay, that's the end of part one. Part two is in the next video.